Gaurav, you've bagged this big ticket show called Foundation. Everybody now by now knows about it. We've seen the trailer, we've seen you in it, and you come in the show from the third episode onwards. Firstly, I want to take you back and ask you, since it's a big show on a world platform, how does one back something like this?
No, I think honestly, I back my conviction,
right.
But it is the makers, the producers, the writers, the entire team who is backing their vision.
Right.
And when they sit around and say, you know what, let's embark on this global casting phenomena,
mm-hmm.
and let us pick a character who right. is going to represent a whole different planet. A planet has a different language, a different look, a different feel.
Mm-hmm.
And maybe this difference can come from India. Maybe right. this difference could come from Southeast Asia. And you're just like, let me go there and just remember the lines and do a good job.
Right.
The audition for me was my one step process towards, you know, us sitting here and talking to each other. You know, it started right. from there.
Literally. Right.
24th of September 2019 is where the journey of Farah truly began.
Right.
You know, if I had a chance, that chance began here in India, along with Tess Joseph, who called me to the room to audition for Farah Kain.
So okay. Yes. Lovely. And I think we did run into each other when you were off to LA, but you didn't
yes.
tell me anything about it. Thank you for that.
Yes.
Right.
No idea, but I think you'll be interviewing me soon.
Yeah. I remember that. And I just, I was like, completely excited about it because the fact that you were going to LA, that much I found out just by seeing your boarding card. So I figured that this is something really big. So now coming to it's based on a book. Did you read the book? Did you think it was important to read it?
You know, that's a very interesting question. All right. So I think I've been fortunate in one way
okay.
that, you know, the characters that have been written for me to play in both these mammoth, you know, novel masterpieces that I've been a part of.
Right.
Neither of these novels have Farah or another character that I've played in the books.
Right.
It wasn't something that was directly linked with me to gain knowledge of this character or their worlds.
Right.
That being said, I think an epic compilation of Isaac Asimov's grandest work that has
right.
been the inspiration for robotics AI today in the world that we live in, and
right.
for the fact that it has been an inspiration for films like Star Trek, Star Wars,
yeah.
Dune most recently, you know, and many other science fiction shows. I personally look at it as, you know, I wish when I was younger, my parents or, you know, friends or family pushed me in the direction of reading books. So,
right.
For
yeah.
somebody who is a science fiction fan, so
mm-hmm.
to speak,
mm-hmm.
you read these books when you were 12 years old. You
right.
read these books when you were 14 years old. But when I was really given the script, that became my
yeah. right.
gospel truth. That became what I had to read and understand. Because
right.
if I spent more time understanding things that were outside the books, you know, just to gain an inspiration, I may miss out on what was really written by the creators
right.
for me to do justice to this. And I think I'm somebody who likes to draw from the lines, likes to draw from what's been written in terms of visual representation that
mm-hmm.
you would see on screen. So
right.
I spent as much time as possible. Like the cupboard behind me has a shelf dedicated to the entire script, like every
okay.
single amendment of the script of Foundation from episode 1 till episode 10.
Right.
So for me, that became material to deep delve into. I wanted to know more about this character through what was conceived for this character.
Right.
So will I go back and read Foundation when, you know, the storm has calmed? Yes,
yeah.
I will.
You will.
But
okay.
did I, in order to prepare for this character? No, I didn't.
No, okay, right. Yeah, it's best to go with the script. Right. You know, while we're chatting, I also want to show a picture of your character. You know, talking to an audience that's not seen it yet, and we want them to watch it, right? So what can you tell about your character that they are watching on the screens right now?
Sarah is badass. She's driven by fury. She's got a single agenda.
Okay.
And she carries a lot of pain in her heart, like a lot of pain in her heart.
Right.
She's manipulative when it requires and suits her purpose.
Okay.
She's kind and gentle, mm-hmm. not for too long.
Right.
She is just driven by this blind fury to mm-hmm. end the empire. So the first two episodes clearly,
right.
you know, tell you how terrible the empire was to
right.
the planet.
Right.
So it's not just her personal loss.
Right.
It's the loss of the planet. Now she represents the planet for her justice.
Mm-hmm.
And the only way that she can draw justice is by embarking on this one sole mission of making
right.
sure Trantor doesn't exist.
Right.
You know, and just to have that one single vision to move mm-hmm. forward, destroy anything and everything that comes into your, that comes, you know, in your way. I think that takes a lot of angst, and
right,
I'm not that
right.
angst. It was a lot of work.
Right, I can imagine. So, you know, y'all are saving humanity, y'all are building civilization. There can't be a perfect theme, even in today's world, for something like this to save humanity, rebuild civilization, and take care of the planet. Is there a message here somewhere?
Oh my God. To me, you know, whether it is through Goodreads or whether it's through my script, what I've understood
right.
is that Isaac Asimov is no short of a philosopher, a genius in his own right. 50
right.
years ago, he decided to say that if Earth was over,
right,
and he had to decide to find, you know, another galactic space
right.
to share our stories, but humans were common to Earth and humans were common to any other interstellar space that we were trying to, you know, feature or picture
right.
ourselves in. If humanity doesn't change, nothing changes.
Nothing changes, right.
Nothing changes. And this is not just a statement, because, you know, we could look at it going like, oh, it's such a dystopian world.
Mm-hmm.
But if you just peek closer to our own lives,
yeah.
you will see that we are living in a dystopian world right
totally,
now.
Totally, totally, yeah, yeah. So ahead of its times, absolutely.
So ahead of its times. He's a philosopher in every single way and mean. And for me, that's nothing short of history. We've just
yeah,
been
yeah.
a part of history.
History, absolutely. You know, for any actor or any technician watching this interview, could you help us understand what is the production like? What is the set like? What did you learn that, you know, you thought, because this is world-class production, it's the quality we all crave for. What was the biggest learning when you were right there in the middle of it?
I just love dancing and romancing to green and blue screens. There were so many of them.
Right.
There were so many of them.
Right.
Just green screens and blue screens. And you're saying these lines. You're picking things up from the air. You're touching your wrist and you're doing things and you're moving your hands and you're looking at nothing with
right.
conviction.
Right.
And then I honestly think we did maybe 40% of the job, but 60% of the job was really like the show.
Yeah.
The 60% of the job is after it's produced, after it's finalized, after it's
post-production.
You see what you were playing with and how everything emerges in front of your eyes. And I thought that as an actor was an incredible journey.
Right.
Because you're doing things out of nothing.
Right.
You know, and but I must tell you, the production designs and the production designers on the show.
Right.
Helped us so much. Like the little props that we had would light up.
Right, right.
They would rotate.
Mm-hmm.
They were usable props.
Right.
Like the space car that I have.
Mm-hmm.
It moves.
Right, right.
It doesn't fly, but it moves. You know, and my bow and arrow. It's a functional bow and arrow.
Right.
It's not just a prop. You know, it's something, and we had like multiple versions of it, the hard
mm-hmm.
version, the soft version, so it doesn't hurt anybody.
Right.
Also, I think as an individual working on a show, I didn't think I ever had to punch somebody in the face, so I never learned how to throw a punch.
Yeah, right.
And now I'm just beating all the good guys, bad guys, just beating everyone up.
Right.
Know? So just to go through so much vigorous training in terms of changing your physicality, in terms of changing your mental mindset, in terms right. of when you throw a punch, you're not throwing it as Kubra, you're throwing it as Farah.
Right.
When you're getting up furious and angry, you're not waking up, you know, from the floor as Kubra, you're waking up as Farah. Mm-hmm. You know, you're not willing to give up. The clothes, every single detail. Mm. Like, I want one extra line of gold.
Right.
Because she's the Grand Huntress of War.
Right.
You know, I think these are the little things that can't help you escape the reality that you're doing this. You know?
Right. Yeah.
This is reality at the moment. And I thought that was just stupendous as an experience even.
Right. You know, we're reaching the end of the interview. For an audience that's not watched it, do you want to tell them where to watch, when to watch, how much of it is out, and how, you know, since there's so much choice on OTT platforms, across platforms, what do you want to tell them?
Okay, so here I go again. So Foundation dropped on Apple TV Plus on the 24th of September. The first two episodes are out. Farah as a character makes her entry. In the third episode, that's me. Please watch Farah. Please watch her journey. She's wicked. She's wild. She's mental. But this is the interesting thing. With all the choices that one has, mm-hmm. you know, with all the OTT platforms existing and all the content that is out there, the reason why I would probably pick Apple TV Plus is because it gives you the best. You know, it gives you the most feel-good content and gives you the content that makes you seep into your thoughts mm-hmm. and form your own reality. So I think it's time for every single audience member to pique your curiosity. Have that curiosity to know what Foundation is all about. You don't need to be a sci-fi fan. You don't need to be a Kubra fan. You don't need to be a David Boyer fan. You don't need to be anybody's fan.
Right.
You just need to have the curiosity to know, how can somebody create this universe that is so larger than life?
Right.
That doesn't even exist in today's times, but has relevance to today's times.
Right.
So I think if you do that, this show is for you. This show is for everyone.
Right. Great. Fantastic. So on that note, we'll end this and continue to make us proud by doing these big ticket international shows as well while you entertain us here as well. Thank you. Always lovely chatting with you, Kubra.
Thank you so much, Ro.